Friends, today we'll discuss how to select doctor. A common refrain is that all optionals are scoring. I don't think there can be any debate about it. But the point is, all optionals are not scoring for everyone. If that were the case, then all the optionals would have same percentage of people qualifying. But that you do not see in the annual reports every year released by UPSC. There are subjects that give better results than others, some consistently, some erratically. Most of you, despite having your own engineering background, you are not going for your own subject. Why? One thing is that generally it is heard that you should take up as optional the subject that was there in your graduation and post-graduation. But how can you take up if you have electronics as your option, as your engineering subject, or computers, or say biophysics, biochemistry, molecular biology? So you have to be a bit wise in deciding. If you had a civil engineering, you are not likely to take, most likely because that is too lengthy, that is what you think. Or mechanical. The fact is that while you were studying, you were just concerned with your score. Anything about 8.5 would be good. Not really concerned about whether you are going to take this subject in UPSC, so you should apply yourself to that. So you ruled out engineering. But people do qualify. Similarly, medicine, they study for 5.5 years. Again, that's very lengthy. The time you utilize to prepare your engineering as your background or medicine as your background, in that time, if you revise that, in that time you can prepare a new social science as an optional. So time-wise, and another thing about medical science is that the results are quite unpredictable. 1 year you will find 20% plus qualifying. Next year you may find 6% qualifying. There are people who come to me and they ask about what was the maximum score. If you are looking for maximum score, then I would advise you go for mathematics. Mathematics, we give an example that is ideal. So and so subject has mathematical marking. Sanskrit too can be similar to that. But will you go for maths or Sanskrit? M.Techs or even M.Sc.s from DU will think 10 times, 20 times before they opt for maths. Zoology and botany can be good subjects, but again many people don't go for it. The reason is botany is very lengthy. Just one topic of botany, taxonomy, can be as big as any social science optional. Luckily, it is not that much in that detail in the UPSC syllabus, but otherwise also it's lengthy. Zoology, again, though it's not very lengthy, but paper one is highly theoretical, chordates and non-chordates. Plenty of diagrams are required, and if you are not good at diagrams, and paper two, the doctors, the kind of approach they have, they score more than even MSc Zoo. So what is the option for you? Social sciences. And in social sciences also you have very limited options. There are people who will go for psycho. or philosophy. Why? Their interest. Why? Because all Indians are philosophers, all Indians are psychologists. But psychology, if you look at the UPSC annual reports, is not performing well for the last several years. Sociology is good, definitely very good, very interesting, helps in social issues also. But the problem is that in thinkers are there, in paper one there are 5 thinkers. But whole of social paper one is based on thinkers. And thinkers of social sciences do not appear good, do not convince those with the scientific orientation of mind. Otherwise too, sociology and philosophy, these are pure social sciences. And pure social sciences means you should have very good written skills. And the kind of background you people have, mostly doctors, engineers, commerce graduates, you have everything but written skills. History is definitely a very good subject. Covers a lot of general studies as well, including world history. But then length definitely is a matter. Besides your interest, if you have interest in history, history definitely can be a good subject, and also geography. Irony is that at school level throughout the country we do not have good geography teachers, and that's why interest is not generated at school level. But when you go for coaching and general studies, then you realize that this geography is different, what you studied was different. Can be good. The only thing is, it's very lengthy. The first chapter in geomorphology, geography, geomorphology, you can say it's as big as, or maybe slightly more than paper 2 of anthropology. Then you have public ed. Most popular subjects are geography and public ed. Public ed will never lose its popularity. The reason is that the newcomers, they are fascinated with the subject for 2 reasons. Firstly, while you are going to administration, so you must have the knowledge of public administration. The question is, if you are learning administration here, what will they teach you in Mussoorie? And second logic given is that one whole paper of general studies is taken care of by public ed. Definitely true. But on an average, the people that score in pub ed, in the class itself you will find many people, not many, but some people who have left pub ed after appearing twice or thrice. Some may be with geography and left, or psychology and left. Because they don't score more than 180, 190 when the other subjects are scoring 240, 250. On an average, I'm saying. So if you score 10 marks more than others in general studies paper 2, but 30, 40, 50 marks less than other optionals, then that won't be a wise decision. Economics is definitely a very good subject. Day-to-day life is governed by economics. Micro and macroeconomics, you have read in your general studies also. But previous background is essential. Those from Delhi School of Economics, they relish taking this subject. And not only that, it helps you in general studies. It helps in your day-to-day life. It helps in demography. It helps in a bit of social issues as well. The best subject should be political science, except for its length. If you have interest, current nationals and internationals, if you have been reading for the last 2, 3, 4 years, it covers current nationals, internationals, UN, Indian polity. If you have interest and if you are not worried about length, then definitely political science is definitely a good subject. And then you have public ed, I told you, polity part is there only. Then law is there. Very interesting, but lengthy. And you require the most recent cases discussed and concluded by Supreme Court. So if you have interest and you are updated in the latest FIRs, then definitely law fetches. And those of you who have done 5 years course in law, these days it's common. So that can be a good option for you. These days, if you talk about the surrounding areas, anthropology is uprising. It's a different thing that people have never heard about anthropology before, the science of man. Syllabus looks lengthy. The syllabus is released in Employment News, and botany seems half of anthropology. If you measure an inch tape. But botany is very lengthy. And those who know botany, they would realize that anthropology may be 3 or 4 times shorter than botany. Otherwise also, those of you who are worried about anthropology, biological aspects, most of the commerce graduates are there or engineers are there. +2 level biology is good enough. And that much of biology, you are also required for your general studies. Otherwise, people say syllabus is small, it's static, nothing is static in UPSC. Of course, annual report every year released, Tribal Affairs Ministry. That is the only change that takes place. Or a news in genetics, or a news in fossils. But when you write answers, everything is dynamic. Any subject, general studies, essay, everywhere. Anthropology can be an option if you have interest in man, if you have interest in social relations. Anthropology does help in all the social issues which they ask in your general studies. And paper 2 of anthropology, as also sociology, they help in building essay, the framework of essay. Now, anthropology is dearest to me because I have been drinking anthropology, eating anthropology, breathing anthropology for the last 45 years. I like it, but it doesn't mean that you should go for anthropology. And I have reason to tell you that way also, because it's my commerce. I say it's good and you take it. That's no logic. You have to decide. You may be surprised to know that in all these years, I have never asked anybody to take anthro. I always said that you decide and then leave the things to me. For me, that is a wonderful subject. And that is why I started coaching as well. Before that, I was good enough in my job as a journalist. So anthropology is one of the options that you can take. And it not only can help you in becoming IAS, it can help you in becoming a better human. But that it's no invitation for you to join anthro or to join VedSciences. Many subjects are there. They can be taken up depending on your liking. But irony is that whenever we choose any optional, blindly we choose. There can be certain requisites while deciding. Like people who come for anthropology to me, they said syllabus is small. How can you know syllabus is small just because others have said? There are others who say it has social issues. Sociology also has social issues. A number of reasons can be there. First thing is, I always ask people, when you go to purchase vegetables, you look for 4, 5, 6 shops and then you decide what to do and from where. But when you have to talk about saying about optionals, you never think twice. Just because somebody said certain requisites, firstly look at the syllabus. Can you comprehend? Second thing is look for the material or guidance, whether it is available. Third thing is previous year's results that you can see in annual report of UPSC. And one more reason can be advice of others. That can be one more reason. Your seniors can be there. These days you are very fond of net. Plenty of websites are there. You can chat and you can decide. And then you lay a hand on 1, 2, 3. Try to read a bit. And whatever convinces you, you take up. Just because I have been teaching anthropology for the last, say, 32 years or 37 years, either way you count, it doesn't mean that I will recommend anthro. You have to decide. It has to be your choice, your selection.